bonitas, and welcome back to my channel. So my name is Alejandra, for those of you who are new, which I know I have a lot of new subscribers right now, so welcome. And if you are new here and you haven't subscribed, go ahead and click that button down below. Now today I'm gonna go ahead and talk about all the newborn must-haves. My baby is now 1 month old. She just turned 5 weeks yesterday, so I wanted to give like a rundown of all the things that I've actually used from like my bedside nursery, from my actual nursery. That way you guys know exactly what you guys need to have before you guys welcome your tiny little baby home. Now one of the very first things, and I'm going to start off with like the bigger items. Of course, if you're going to room share with your baby, you definitely need a bassinet. My bassinet, it's not like an all-time favorite. My bed is really high, so I have to like look down to check her, but definitely you need a bassinet. And my baby is like used to like the vibration motion that it has, so that has been really helpful. I would prefer her to self-soothe, which we're working on, but if you want like a vibration and little songs and lights for your baby, then the bassinet that I have is for you. Just keep in mind it's a bit shorter than other ones and you can't adjust it. Another item that we definitely use every single day is our diaper genie. As a newborn, you will go through diapers like this, like so many diapers. Literally every 2-3 hours we change her diaper, because that's how much she eats. So she wets her diaper and she hates being in wet diapers, so we definitely change her diaper every time we're gonna feed her, because right after she falls asleep and we don't want to wake her up after, so we change her diaper. The genie must have. You don't even smell that there was a diaper changed in the bedroom. So we definitely keep that in the room. We actually had that in the nursery. We moved it to our bedroom. And it's been like a lifesaver when it comes to like keeping the smell away. Now, talking about smells and also air purifying, we purchased an air purifier before she got here, tried it out, loved it. Now that we do have her and we're trying to keep all kinds of smells away from her and just keep the air purified, we keep it in our bedroom, have it running through the night. It has 3 settings, which one is like really low, medium, and high. And the one when it's in the really low one, you can barely even hear it, so you can't hear it throughout the night, which I absolutely love. And by the way, I'm gonna link all these items down below, and that's just like an extra precaution on us parents for our baby. So if you definitely want to keep your air purified in your bedroom or wherever the baby's at, then definitely purchase that, and it was from Amazon. Now the other item that definitely we have also been using, and this is one of the smaller items, and I actually have the smaller items here with me so I can show you guys. This one we recently purchased about a week or two ago. I really like it. We're still trying to see if she kind of likes it. I wish I would have had this as soon as she came home, because that way she would have been used to it. She was just used to blankets and she doesn't even like her hands down. That's why we bought this one, so she can put her arms up, but she likes moving her hands a lot, and she's so little for her to be moving her hands so much. So I bought her this. I'm not sure if she absolutely loves it, but she did sleep a really long time in it the first night that we put it on her. The night after, not so much, but she was just being fussy. But I would recommend this one, because I feel like it's much safer for her to sleep like this than with the blankets, because she wiggles her arms out and then the blanket gets loose and I'm scared it'll be on her face. So I rather have this, and that way everything is contained and she's like exactly how I set her down that night. So I love this. Now what you definitely need to have like a million of by your bed, by your nursing chair, wherever you're nursing, in the nursery room, in the diaper bag, you need to have like a couple of these burp rags. I really like these. I also have like the little regular like these little ones. I have these little ones too, which work well as well, but I don't know why we've all gravitated to these long ones. And she's not a baby that spits up so much. But when we're feeding her, like, the milk will come down the sides. And then, you know how babies, like, have stinky little necks if the milk stays in and they have the creases and you can't really get in there until you bathe them. So these have definitely been, like, our holy grail. Like, we carry one of these upstairs, downstairs. There's one, like, everywhere because we absolutely love these. And then if they fall on the ground and it's dirty, you can't use it anymore. So then we have, like, the backup one. So definitely, absolutely love, love, love these burp rags. Now, when it comes to the stinky necks as well, I like using these. These were actually gifted to us. It's a hand and face wipe. I really, really, really like these. They have, like, a nice little scent to them. And, you know, I clean her face and her hands because, like I said, she's very active with her hands. So she's always, like, pulling on our clothes, our hair, or everything. So I definitely want to keep her hands clean. And, you know, if people are, like, visiting and they're, like, grabbing their hands and stuff, I definitely want to clean them right after. And then it also helps with, like, the milky stinkiness. So that these have been really good. Now, also one thing that I use every single day for her is this booger. I don't even know what it's called. It's called Nose Frida, I think. Yeah, it says it on here. Nose Frida. It's to, like, suction out her boogers. At first I thought it was like, ew, like, why do I want to, like, suck her boogers out? But obviously nothing makes it to your mouth. It literally stays right here. And then it won't even, like, it will suck the booger out enough for you to, like, pick it out with a napkin or with a tissue. But I absolutely love this because babies can only breathe through their nose. They cannot mouth breathe. So if they have blockage or something in their nose, then it doesn't help for them to be comfortable. They get all fussy. Well, at least for her, like, you'll hear her, like, nose whistling or whatever if she has a little booger in there. So I'll take her boogers out every morning just so she's good throughout the day. And I've also noticed that if her boogers are a little dry, I'll turn on the Frida humidifier. So definitely add that to your list. I really, really like it, and it even helps Peter and I at nighttime. We turn it on if we're feeling congested or, like, you know, whatever, stuffy, then that humidifier will help. And we haven't even put any drops in it of any kind. It's literally just the water, and it'll help us breathe better. So I can only imagine how much better it helps our baby. But definitely this is a must have. And if you're not in the nursery, which right here we have the changing pad, but of course in the nighttime I just change her on the bed. But we did have an poop accident on my comforter once, and I was like, oh my god, is it gonna stain forever? It didn't stain forever. We washed it right away. We added vinegar and voila, it removed. But we have these liners. They're from the brand Munchkin. We got them at Target. I literally just lay it down, lay her right on top, just in case of any accident. It's on here and not on my comforter ever again. So on this side it's like soft and warm, and this side it's like a plastic, so it doesn't go through. So I absolutely recommend these. We use these most of the time. I'm the one that's up since I'm breastfeeding, so I'll go ahead and lay this down before I lay her down to change her diaper, regardless of if it's a poop or pee diaper. Now, our baby, talking again about spit up and stuff like that, our baby does not, like, throw up. Like I said, she doesn't spit up. She kind of, like, keeps it in her mouth. The little that she does spit up, she keeps it in her mouth, and she, like, kind of, it sounds like if she's biting it, obviously no teeth, but it sounds like if she's biting it. And then I've always been scared that she'll choke on it. So the hospital gave us a couple of these, which are, I don't even know what these are called, suction pumps, I don't know. But we keep this, I literally keep this on my nightstand, so if I hear her, like, struggling or choking or something, I literally grab it and I suction whatever's in her mouth out. These are amazing. I have, like, the ones that come in, like, the gift sets and stuff. They don't work that well, and even the nurse at the hospital said, I'm gonna give you a couple of these because the ones that they sell out at the store suck. So definitely this ones have came through. It literally will suck anything out. So I usually just stick it through the side and suction whatever's, like, right here, since that's where it accumulates for her. It definitely works. Now, clean it every single day, because one that we hadn't used in a while, we didn't clean, and when I was cleaning it, like, black stuff was coming out, so I'm sure it was like moldy. So I cleaned it with hot water, sterilized it, but I stick to the one I use all the time. So now I make sure to have this cleaned before I use it on her all the time, because we don't need a baby to get sick. And then, like I've mentioned on Instagram, and if you guys don't follow me yet, follow me at Styles by Ms. Ale. My baby has been a little bit fussier. She won't nap, like I've mentioned to you guys. So gripe water. Gripe water has been a holy grail for our baby. So definitely speak with your doctor before giving your baby anything. But gripe water has helped her for, like, let's say if she has gas and can't really, like, pass it through, since she doesn't like to be burped. So instead of being burped, I've noticed that she farts it out. So sometimes her tummy will, like, kind of not, like, allow her to or whatever. So we'll give her this. My baby gets hiccups every single day, so we'll give her a little bit of this, and it says it's supposed to help with fussiness. We have noticed that once we give her at least, we just give her like one dose, because it says you can give it to her up to like 6 times a day. I'm like, well, that is way too much. We only give her once if needed, not every day. And it helps with fussiness as well. If, I mean, it says on here, I don't know if it does, but I have seen that it helps her, like, kind of relax and go to sleep if she's trying to fight her sleep. I Googled what it consists of, and I've seen that it has like, chamomile tea in it, and ginger and stuff like that, which is like stuff that us in the Hispanic households, or my mom's like, give her té de manzanilla or té de tila. I have not, because I'm scared and you're not supposed to, according to the doctors. But I saw that this medicine has it, so I'm like, okay, well, it's in there, then we'll just let it do its thing and then just rock her to sleep. Now, another thing that I bought, even though my baby hates pacifiers, she hates pacifiers, but I found these little cases on Amazon as well. It came in a pack of two. I keep these in here. I keep these in her diaper bag regardless, because if I'm in the car, I can't put my boob in her face, and I'm kind of scared to give her a bottle while in the car, because if she chokes on the milk or something, then I can't, like, quickly take her out and pat her back. I have to, like, unbuckle her and then put her back. Like, that just gives me anxiety. So I carry these with me regardless if she likes it or not. It would kind of soothe her a little bit. But definitely she hates them. But the point is, get these little plastic containers to keep any germs and stuff out. I also have the wipes to clean them or sanitize them. She hardly uses pacifiers, so I haven't really used them, but I at least keep these in here in the diaper bag so it doesn't get, like, the lint from all the other clothes and stuff. Now, for the small things, I think that's it. Now, for me, for mommy, I just bought this recently, the Hakka, and oh my goodness, it is amazing. I did also see, like, the smaller, the ladybug one that you just pop in your bra. But I absolutely love this one because, let's say, for example, last night she slept for about 5, almost 6 hours, you guys. And that's just because I, like, woke her up at the 5 hour mark. I was like, no, girl, you need to eat and you need to change your diaper. Like, I was just paranoid that she was sleeping so long because it was the first night she did that. So I woke up before that at, like, around 4 a.m. to pump, because I noticed that she wasn't waking up, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna let her sleep like an hour more. So I woke up to pump because my boobs were, like, humongous and they started hurting. So I put the breast pump on one, and while I put the breast pump on one breast, I put this on the other, and I you squeeze it twice to kind of give it like a suction, and it'll just catch the letdown and kind of, like, pump some of the milk also, because I actually got like 2 ounces just using this. It was not even like an actual, like, pump that's like suctioning everything. Just using this, I got like 2 ounces, and then once I was done with this breast, then I went ahead and put it on here, and total I filled up one of the Komotomo bottles. So that was amazing. I highly recommend this, like, for the nighttime or whenever you're just breast pumping, but highly recommend it. or you can also use it while the baby's breastfeeding on one and you can hook it up on the other side for that letdown. But I absolutely loved it. But my baby just eats so much. Like she eats so, I feel like she eats so much for her age, that when we went to her first appointment, the doctor said to give her about 1.5 ounces of formula so she can actually get full, because she wasn't getting full just off my breast. So we do have formula as backup whenever like we see that she's fussy, that she's still hungry, we give her that. So because of that, we have the Brezza water warmer. It's not the Keurig look-alike one that mixes the formula for you, because I didn't plan to formula feed, so I didn't want to buy that. But we were gifted the water warmer, which is what I wanted, and we originally had that in the kitchen, but once we saw that she needed like that 1.5 ounces at night, we were not gonna go up and down these stairs. So we brought it to our bedroom. We have the Brezza water warmer, and we have like the baby water that we, the gallon water that we buy at Target, we also use that, and it heats it up for you right away, and then you literally just press it down, and I'll add links of everything so you guys can see what I'm talking about. We just press it down, water comes out, and we put the formula in ourselves, because it's not something that we use all the time. So we just have it that way. We don't want the one that looks like the baby Keurig. But definitely if you're going to be formula feeding, at least subsidizing from breast milk, then I highly recommend that. Now if you're going to be strictly formula feeding, then you would probably want the one that looks like the baby Keurig. But I love this water warmer because, I mean, it's a lifesaver. We don't have to go up and down these stairs. Now going back to the going up and down these stairs, whenever we're downstairs in the living room or kitchen or whatever, just hanging out down there, we have a like a little caddy. It's just like a little cute little pink basket, and we stock it up with wipes, with diapers, rash cream. I don't really use it. I've only used it a couple of times, but I still have it in there, since I have one in the bedroom, one in that diaper caddy, and then we have burp cloths in it. So if you live in a two-story house or in a house where the nursery or your bedroom is really far away from like the kitchen and living room, I highly recommend you have like a little basket or something in your most common place, to that way you're not like walking up and down the stairs or running around the house trying to get stuff for your crying baby, or when you're changing diapers you don't want to be like, oh my god, I don't have wipes, I have to go get that, and the baby's like half naked because the diaper's off already. So definitely get that. It's just very convenient. Now for my nighttime diaper changes, you know how I mentioned I use that liner. So a lot of people told me to not get a wipey warmer. It's a waste of money. It dries out the wipes. Like all this negative stuff. But I cannot live without my wipey warmer, because my baby does not like cold wipes on her butt. So we literally use that every single day. Like there's no day that we don't use this wipey warmer. If we're out, which we haven't even been out, obviously we're not going to carry the wipey warmer, but we'll just warm it up in our hands. But in the middle of the night when it's 3-4 a.m. you don't want to just sit there and warm up the wipey with your hands. And even though it's been hot here in California, like my baby still does not like the cold wipes. So I use that religiously. I personally like it. That's a personal choice. Like I said, a lot of people said, don't buy it, it's a waste of money, da, da, da. But I really like it. I'm gonna continue using it, and I can only imagine how much more helpful it's gonna be now that it's gonna start to get cold and winter's coming. So I absolutely like it. I'm gonna keep using it. It's completely up to you, but I recommend it. But that's definitely what I recommend for newborns. I'm trying to think if I'm missing anything else. I actually made a list on my phone. Okay, so for mommy as well, nursing pads are a must. I know that there's some that you can wash and put in your bra. I don't have time for that, honestly. Like, as soon as I am able to get a quick shower in, I will just throw on like the the disposable ones, the ones that come in that purple box, Laneige or I don't know, the brand is something like that, but I get the disposable ones. I use those religiously every single day. So you definitely need nursing pads if you're gonna be nursing. Now, baby's nails grow like crazy, so you definitely need a good nail clipper. I clip her nails at least once a week, if not more, because they grow really, really fast. Just be very careful with that. But her nails grow so fast, so definitely you need that. And then she was born with like a little bit of baby acne, so what I've noticed that has helped get rid of most of the little dots on her face is the Aquaphor healing ointment. I actually got 2 or 3 like big bottles of those, and they have actually been working. And you know how like babies also peel, or like they have chapped skin like days or weeks after being born? That will like get it out the way like super fast. Her skin will feel soft, like, because I would see that it would start getting red like on the little creases that were peeling, and I was like, oh my god, that looks like it hurts. So I would put that lotion or that ointment on, and it definitely helped her. I highly recommend it. And then what else do I recommend for you guys? Okay, and I know I've mentioned a lot of the times, or in another video, the breast friend nursing pillow or whatever. Yeah, it's a nursing pillow, but it's like a more sturdy flat one. I cannot live without it. I mean, I can't even imagine how moms do it without having something other than regular pillows. Regular pillows are just not the same as having something like strapped onto you that keeps that support and doesn't allow the baby to slip like right between you and the pillow. So this one, like, you strap it on, it's flat, the baby lays on there. I still like hold her, and I hold my breast to like keep her there. She's still little, so she needs that help. But I absolutely love that pillow. So definitely, if you're looking to nursing and you want to save your back at least a bit, definitely get the My Breast Friend. And also, if you want to just have your baby lounge around while you guys are watching TV or something like that, then I recommend the Dockatot. I don't have the actual brand Dockatot one, but I have like they gifted me like a different brand. I don't even know what it is, but I've noticed that my baby likes lounging around in that more than like the swings or like the bouncer. So weird, because she'll get entertained on the swing looking at like the little toys hanging from it for like a little bit, but if I leave her on the Dockatot, she'll like just chill there. Even though she's not looking at anything else, she'll just chill, and for a much longer period. And last but not least, these last two things are also a must. Muslin blankets, everyone needs, because when you first bring the baby home, you want to swaddle them in that because they hardly move. So muslin blankets are amazing, and they're lightweight. My baby gets hot really fast. She's sweating like if she's in 100 degrees inside the house, but she will sweat through. So the muslin blankets, which are lightweight, really, really have come through. And the last item is the Moby. I'm pretty sure that's how you say it, the Moby wrap or whatever, like the one you strap her on. It's just like a long piece of linen, and you strap it on yourself, you tie it on yourself and have the baby right here. She is becoming very needy, so she cannot let me do stuff unless she's like with me or if I'm napping with her. And while she naps, I like to do stuff around the house, and if she cannot nap, then I cannot do stuff. So I'll strap her on, and actually right now Peter's the one taking care of her, and we strapped her on him, and she's been knocked out for like an hour or more. So that's why you do not hear a crying baby. That's why I've been like lagging it with these videos, because I'm like, I'm either always breastfeeding and no time to do makeup. Like, this is the first day I actually put like a full-blown Okay, my camera had died, but I'm back. So like I was saying, this is my first time putting in a full face of makeup on, and I'm so excited. I actually want to get a couple pictures to put on the gram. So like I said, if you don't follow me yet, follow me at Styles by Miss Ale. But those are all the items that you need, of course, also diapers and your car seat and stuff like that. And of course, a diaper bag, which let me tell you, it was a struggle trying to figure out what actually goes in a diaper bag because I don't know, I just threw a whole bunch of stuff in there thinking I was gonna need them, but I don't really need anything. But I'll do a whole nother video on that, letting you guys know exactly what you need when you go out, because you don't want to just carry extra stuff or under carry stuff in there. So that is it for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. Do not forget to like and subscribe. Leave a comment down below if you are also expecting, or if this video was helpful to you, or let me know what is a must-have for you and your newborn so that I can check it out and maybe it'll help me too. But that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. You guys have a great rest of your day. Bye.